Well, I would like to introduce the panelists here. Mr. Mahendra Vakaria, President, Outbound Tour Operators Association of India. Next, we have Manoj Gurusahani, Chairman, US India Investors Forum. He will also be moderating the session. And we also have Mr. Peter Bruhn, Chief Communications Officer, VFS Global.
So welcome once again. And we're discussing pre-panel about the whole aspects of the growth in the outbound travel market. And I guess this being a very specific show, OTM, which talks about the outbound travel. And when I was looking from here and we were discussing, it looks like it's like a mini WTM here, and there's so many booths, countries, and very lot of states represented, and largely a B2B show. So I'm sure most of you all are from the B2B industry, encompassing all the various relevant stakeholders of the tourism and travel industry. And so we'll kick off by, I would ask a question to Peter. In terms of Peter, we were discussing in the growth of, and you were saying you're very buoyant and optimistic on how the outbound travel market, especially from India, is looking at. So can you just expand on that?
Since for the UK and the Schengen countries, you have to give your biometrics, you must come to the visa application centers. We don't often see them then half day booked through a travel agent or half day booked online. Yes, they have to give the kind of booking confirmations for hotel and flights as part of the requirements by the governments for a visa application. So we don't have a data that shows what comes purely online and what not. There, of course, we would know that younger people probably would rather do online, like we see it all over the world. But maybe then they make their experience with some mistakes, and they wish they had some trusted advisors, especially when they go abroad, for example, to Europe and spend quite a bit of money. But we would not see that. What we see is, and that's maybe an indication that they did it online, they're not so well prepared with the documentation. They come very short term, because probably young people think, oh, visa application process, yes, it's a kind of a hassle. We try to make it hassle-free as possible. And the ones that were in queues in front of embassy 20 years ago, they know exactly what it is. It is a smooth process today, especially out of India. But they think, yeah, let's do this quick, and they are not so prepared. They might get a visa rejection then. And also, they do it too short-term, especially when the peak season comes, because usually we give a visa application within 24 hours to the embassy. But in the embassy, it takes then 15 working days, but during peak season, this can go up to 30 working days. Depends on the mission, on the government, and people are not thinking of that. And I think travel agents are better prepared for that, because they know, apply much earlier. And there I could see maybe these people have then gone rather online instead of going to a travel agent.
Also, the topic today is what's different in 2019. And to start with, I'll address some of the trends that we are foreseeing in what we've been seeing in the last one and a half years that's emerging. One of the largest trend that's emerged is a term that is getting popular in this industry called bleisure, which is a combination of business trip combined with an extended holiday for leisure. So eventually or effectively, many Indians and many youngsters who are into business, who are entrepreneurs on their own, they've just started a startup or they're an entrepreneur, they are exploring going out of India for their business activity. It could be an attending a conference, could be an attending a trade show, exhibition for a technology type, whatever. But when doing that, they are also extending the trip by a couple of days and adding a little bit of leisure and tourism activity. So that's a combination of business and visitor together, which is one of the biggest trends that we are seeing happening continuously. Another big trend that is happening from India and which is also driven by the Instagram is women-only travel. You know, a lot of ladies groups are making their own small groups of 10, 15, and they're traveling together for a holiday within India or out of India, it doesn't matter. But it's a group of ladies, and they have, the best thing is in their tours, everything is, you know, top of the line, because they want the best of the shopping, they want the best of the food experience, they want the best of the spa treatments, and of course the parties seen in the evening. So that's a new trend that's emerging.